Hello, this is Dr. Andrew Scheckman. I'm here to tell you about STDMeister, the newest medical reference for iPhone and iPod Touch from MeisterMed, now available in the App Store. STDMeister, as you can probably tell from the name, is a guide to diagnosis and treatment of sexually transmitted infections. It also includes step-by-step algorithms and an image atlas with more than 200 images to help you make the diagnosis. Here we're at the home page here. You can get to this page anytime by clicking the home icon on the navigation bar at the bottom. We're going to go through and see what's in here. So we'll start off with the topic index. This is an alphabetical listing of everything in STDMeister. You can see it includes specific diseases like gonococcal infections and condyloma acuminata, but it also includes subject matters like diagnosis and follow-up recommendations to help you quickly get to the information you want. Let's say you want to learn about, you have a patient with genital warts. You can click on W, warts genital, and then you're at a page here that's sort of a clearinghouse for all the information in STDMeister. It has a link to the atlas with all the images of genital warts. And these buttons added in are to step-by-step algorithms to help you with treatment decisions. Any of the links on this page go to that specific section in the Center for Disease Control's STD treatment guidelines, so you can read more about that topic. Let's say we have a patient who's pregnant with genital warts, and we quickly want to know what our treatment options are. We'll click this algorithm button next to the pregnancy, and here we're taken to treatment options for external genital warts in pregnancy. Let's say we want to use TCA, and it gives us all the tips for using TCA in pregnancy. Pretty easy. Let's go back to the home page and see a more detailed treatment algorithm. Let's say, and this is a whole list of the various treatment algorithms available. Let's say we want to treat a patient with herpes. Just click on H. There's herpes genital. And the algorithm asks us a few questions. Is the patient pregnant? Is it neonatal herpes, severe complicated disease, or HIV infection? In this particular patient I'm thinking about, none of those apply. So I'll click the none apply. Then it asks, is it the first episode or a recurrent episode? This particular patient, it's not the first, so we click recurrent. Then it tells us our treatment options include suppressive or episodic therapy, but it also gives us this option to help us choose, you know, guide us to the right decision. I'll choose that. It asks, does the patient have more than 6 episodes in a year? This particular patient does, so I'll click yes. And it tells me that the options include suppressive and episodic therapy. Whichever of those I choose, I click that link, and it gives me the specific drug and dosing regimens that are recommended for that specific situation. Pretty fast, pretty easy. The image atlas in STDMeister has more than 200 images. Many are high resolution color images. Most are high resolution color images. And this is a subject list. You can see, let's say you want to look at syphilis images. You can either click on the syphilis link here and see all of the syphilis images on one page, or you can choose a specific subcategory. For instance, here, let's keep it G-rated and look at secondary syphilis of the hands and feet. We see, in this page, we see thumbnails of all of the images that are syphilis on the hands and feet, secondary syphilis. And we can scroll up through the various options. It looks like there's about 20 images detailing that, so a lot of variations. Now here we can click on the image or on the detail button. If we click on the detail button, we see a description of that particular image and its source attribution. If we click on the image then, or the image from that initial page, we see a full screen version of the image and then can use the iPhone's pinch zoom to enlarge a particular area and sort of pan over and see something a little bit closer up. So that is pretty cool. Next on the hit list is the full text from the Center for Disease Control's STD treatment guidelines. Those were published in 2006, updated in 2007. There's another one coming out in 2010, most likely. But this has the original verbatim text from those treatment guidelines. Let's say you have a patient with trichomonas, you've got a vaginal discharge, trichomoniasis, choose your area. Notice that the background of the text that's taken directly from the CDC's guidelines has a slightly different colored background to help distinguish it from the custom created content for STDMeister. Let's say we want to treat trichomonas in pregnancy. We click that link, and here's the full text from the STD treatment guidelines. It's a little bit wordy, but gives you a lot of background information and references. the step-by-step treatment algorithms are a little bit faster if you just want to get the answer quickly. That's about it. I mean, in addition, here on the navigation bar, you can click this magnifying glass icon to search for any term within STDMeister. Click on the star button to save a favorite page and quickly go back to it whenever you want. Or click on this notes icon to add your own personal notes to any page in STDMeister and get back to it whenever you want. So that's about it. I think you're going to find STDMeister to be fast and easy to use. It'll get you your diagnosis and your treatment recommendations really quickly. And it's a bargain. Get it in the App Store right now. Thanks. Bye.